Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to Lobotomy Corporation Season 4. We are ready to go here for the third rerun of Day 15 because the game will not cooperate whatsoever. Now, what I will say is that I had a video recorded already for this until at the very end in very true Invicta fashion. We ended up losing because the Parasite Tree called somehow five people, even though we only had four buds on there, and I was actively looking around for the fifth one. So I'm going to speed this up really quickly, but I do want to say thank you all very much for the support in Lobotomy Corporation series. I know that this particular spot that we're in right now with the series is not necessarily the most engaging because we have to go through all the remedial steps of having to redo all the abnormalities and stuff. And then again, with the restarts, I understand. I know it is laborious, but it's something that we have to do. Now, I'm going to try my best to not have to restart that often. But the fact of the matter is that if we do end up losing somebody, especially if it's someone like Kurt, we just have to start over again. Because we cannot continue to keep losing the gear that we have no access to, especially when we keep getting nothing but Teths and HE. Now, another thing that I should point out is by this time in any other season for Lobotomy Corporation, we have already gotten an ALEPH before. But again, the one time that we want them to actually show up, we don't get them because, you know, LOLOL. So I'm hoping that the ALEPHs start coming pretty darn soon because we need them to. We really need the gear. I mean, the whole point of doing a season four was because we were going to have the ALEPH gear and we were going to be able to just smoke the rest of the run. But obviously that didn't happen, which is where we find ourselves right now, which is also the reason why I cannot allow a death to go and cost us gear that we can't get to. And again, in my defense, I will say I thought I could have sworn that I could buy out of the codex, which of course we clearly cannot. Taking down the doubt. Not sure what Rhea's doing. Hey Rhea, you want to go help Kurt down there real quick? Team Baynard's gonna deal with that. Tang Sock should have that no problem. We know that Sinvicta's gonna be there. So yeah, so one of the things that obviously we're going to have to make sure we keep that we're aware of is that I need to keep track of the trees. Now, that's going to be a lot easier said than done because we have not one but two trees that can simultaneously call people depending on how many work orders have been given. So that's going to be something that throughout the course of this run is going to be very, very tedious to do. I'm hoping that we don't lose too many people to that fact. Not doing Fairy Festival is that's again another one of those preventative measures that I just sort of am forced to do right now because there is so much to keep track of, which normally has never really been a huge problem for me in the past, but we are at a situation now where we really cannot lose anyone because of the gear situation. So I just wanted to give that a little bit of a primer, a little bit of a backstory, just to say that right now we've got we've got things working against us. We still have the advantage of gear somewhat, but we really need those ALEPHs to start dropping here, and I thank everyone for the patience and understanding through that. Now on to this day. This is the third time I've tried to redo this day because of the trees and that sort of thing. They've been relatively good runs, I would say. But I do need to be careful with the Grave of the Cherry Blossoms. Now, the good thing is that as soon as the Grave of the Cherry Blossoms is done, we never have to work it ever again. So that will no longer become a threat. The Parasite Tree is the one that we have to worry about. So we have the noon. We have the noon event coming up right now. Let's go ahead and send. Who's stronger? Rhea's stronger. I'm going to send NL to get this one started for us. Now the green noon is not that bad. It's just those walking box robots that you had to be real careful with because they can start inside the regenerator, and also they just mow down pawns like nobody's business. So let's take them out fast. I'm not gonna send Tang Sock into work him by himself. We're gonna bring Team Baynard down and just lose some pawns here. Okay, so Tang Sock has two of them in his sector. I'm going to bring Team Sinvicta over here. Tang Sock, you can now help out the Lobies. Okay, they're good. Take out the other one. I think that's the last one. Going to make sure everyone has a shield, of course. Apparently there's one. Oh, there it is. There's one more. It's inside of Tang Sock's. Tang Sock's regenerator. Ah, I was going to try to save her. There we go. All right. Good job, everyone. Well done. I feel like I've said that quite often tonight. Oh, man. Truth be told, we don't have to keep working the cherry blossom tree either, but I do want to make sure that we have completion on it. But we can just stop working it right now. Like I'm through trying to discover what everything does, as far as like new abnormalities go, especially if they have the annoying ability to insta kill somebody. Now, obviously, if it's someone brand new that I've never seen before, then yeah, of course we're going to figure out what the problem is. But I'm through trying to like just like, oh, we're going to go for completion when I know that this particular abnormality is you know, a piece of garbage. Because that at this point, it's just slowing things down. There's no reason for us to keep on doing this unless if something bad happens, like catastrophic happens. So we are now going to start seeing the Grave of the Cherry Blossoms charming people. It's going to be 5 total. There's 1... 2 and 3 are here. Oh, there's one right there. 2. Lost him. I don't think I got him. I definitely didn't get him because the tree is still active right now. This one might be the last one. I may have gotten those other two. Yep, I got him. Okay. Good. I didn't think I clicked enough there, but apparently I did. All right, Tang Sock, keep on working. Keep on working that. I want Baynard's SP to go up. Let's keep going with Eden and Little Daisy switching off there. Let's get NL some more fortitude work. And Husky needs to go into the tree now. Let's see if we can get in there before any employee gets called. Okay, he was able to stop it. I could be utilizing Scarecrow here and just beat him down, but like honestly, like Kurt, everyone on Team Invicta right now has some pretty good stats, especially with Husky getting a little bit of extra help there in the lobotomy sector. Force really needs to get some insight work. I wonder if he can handle if Force can handle just black damage though. What is Force's armor? Force has Vav class armor. Oh yeah, and he's resistant to black. Yeah, so Force should be able to handle Leticia without any issue. I hope. Husky. Okay, we need one more work here for Tang Sock, and then he's done with that. Keep going with Baynard. I want it Baynard's SP. Little Daisy. Let's get our swing off with the woodsman. Yeah, so Force got a good on that. As long as we get good, as long as we don't get normal. Normal is bad. All right, stupid tree is down to 1, but we're done. We're done with working with the Grave of the Cherry Blossom. So Cherry Blossoms has absolutely no reason for us to go in there anymore. Like 0% reason to do that. Eden wants to go work with Lopode. Let's let Force get an easy one now that he had the hard one. Husky can continue to do that. I can go back working on Leticia. Yeah, because Force didn't get a heart, so I should be okay doing that. Pressure work, keep going with Little Daisy. Alright, so we'll go to day 10. Or level 10, I should say. Let me click that. NL. Pode, let's get eating some more fortitude work there. Stupid tree, husky. I could let force work on stupid tree, but I don't really. That's what got me in trouble last time, and I did not notice that stupid tree called somebody and got the fifth blossom. So I'm not even gonna worry. I'm not even gonna handle that. Just simplifying the run is going to be crucial here. Good there. Keep feeding force some SP here. You might even say we're going to force feed him. Go for Eden. And we'll go to one more day here. You know what, Force? Let's see what you can do with the Scarecrow. Actually, does he enrage off of Temperance? No, stop this. Bad. Prudence level 3 or above. Yeah, Prudence level. And Force has 3 Prudence. Yeah, so this is gonna that'll trigger him, but I don't want to. I'm not going to take any risk at this point. I just want this day to be done. And I want to get an ALEPH. Please give us an ALEPH. The one time in forever that I've ever asked for an ALEPH. Now's the time, game. Now's the time. Hangsock got the payout from the cherry blossoms. What? Hangsock's he's blessed, man. All right, Forrest, go work with Leticia. This will be the last day for. This will be the last day for now. The last work order for the day, I should say. Job Forest. She's probably going to give him a heart. Give him a heart. Yes. Yeah, so that's the effect of her is that if we get a normal, she gives a heart out. The force cannot work on anyone else anymore for today, but that's fine because today's about to be over anyway. Let's end it with Baynard, and one more swing on Justice for Little Daisy. That'd be it. Okay, we did it. We finally got past day 15. It's a miracle. How does he do it? I know. As soon as Little Daisy's done. She's done it. Alright. Simvicta got some good temperance gains. Rhea still holding over 100 HP. Baynard only got 3 SP from one bro. Tangsock got a little bit of HP from working with the cherry blossoms. Coach really needed to get SP. NL gained 7 HP. That's good. Force finally getting that SP up. Look at that. Big bump up there for Force. Husky went to 130 SP. Good lord. Working with the tree. Oh my goodness. Eden got a nice fortitude bump and some decent justice ups. Daisy only got 1 HP, but she gained a whole lot. 27 on justice points. That is real good. Wow, I cannot, but that jump though for Husky from 95 to 130 something, that's crazy. Come on, ALEPHs. Papa needs a new pair of everything. Oh, Queen. The color of the human heart is pink. By wearing the same color, we blend into the people's mind. I don't recall that one. Now you become the sky and I become the land. Don't recall that one either, although that one seems more familiar than this one. We know the Snow Queen. We know the Snow Queen, and we know she's good. Do we want to go with... I mean, we're going to have to, so... Don't dangle second truth, man. Nail, how much you know about the company, man? You know anything about this Bobby Corporation? I'm nailed with a big old brain in the back of my head, man. Don't dangle exploited him and all that. Don't dangle special. Again, if you're interested in the story aspect of Lobotomy Corporation, I highly recommend going to check out the beginning of season 3. Definitely watch season three before you watch season four, because we're going to be skipping over a large portion of the story. Now, when we get to story parts and story elements that I have not seen before, of course, then we'll take it in stride. But for all this stuff, I'm not worried about it. All right, we have 19 lobotomy points. We have one more abnormality down here, which I'm just going to leave Tang Sock to go handle, because obviously we don't need to worry about the cherry blossoms anymore. I want Force to be able to work on the tree, so I'm going to move Force down to Teams Invicta. Kurt's not really doing much here, but I have no good reason to move him. So we have 19 lobotomy points. We could make somebody else, but to me, I don't really want to make anyone else right now. Just quite simply put, we don't need somebody else. Right now for body. Well, that's not true. We could put someone else in Tank Sox team. But the thing is that I wouldn't work them though, because we have people that we need to work up here. So let's look at Coach Prendor first. Coach needs a temperance and prudence upgrade, so we can get that for him during the run. I think we can help out Eden a little bit. Yeah, spend 6 points to get him to 4. Little Daisy. Same thing. She has 4s all around. It's not a bad jump. She needs to work Fortitude, though. I wonder if I should move Daisy down. No, she can still work. She can work with Pode. Yeah, so we'll keep those points. Tang Sok definitely needs help for... Yeah, actually, you know what? Let's give Force... How much would it cost to give him full prudence? 5? Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so Force is now more in line with his expectations, but he still has stuff to work on. We'll save the 2 for another employee here. I have seen this abnormality once, I believe. I think it was in season 1. I think it feels like it's been a long time. Well, let's get some insight here. Tells the employee all about love. Oh, good. Ooh. Ooh. Its goal is to keep good-hearted people safe. This is a VOV class. Might even be an ALEPH class, actually. Tank Sock feels hope from its pink color. This is an ALEPH here. It's not melted love, I know that. Or is it? It's definitely an ALEPH. Tang Sock was able to work on it, though. Yeah, it's not... I know it's not Melted Love. This is an ALEPH, though. This is a brand new ALEPH. Melted Love is my dear employees, blah, blah, blah. Interesting. It can be ordered to protect an employee. However, should be noted that the club counter decreased when the order is given. It increases the defense of the employee is protecting while healing everyone in the same area. However, if the level of the employee who is being protected is lower than 3, the employee goes out of control while being protected. Level of counter decreases whenever repression work was finished. The abnormality was made on the idea of Tumblebug backer Moon Jung-ho. Humanoid creatures armed with pink equipment. Its intellectual capacity allows it to verbally converse with human beings. It seems friendly, at least during the observation. It identifies itself as a special force from Redacted and uses the pronoun we when it calls itself. It is continuously showing intention to help humans. Yeah. When has that ever been a true thing? Okay, let's let Force Strategy Gaming work with Stupid Tree here. And let's see. I don't need to work attachment right now. Let's keep going with the justice upgrades for Eden. Daisy really needs SP, so I'm going to let Daisy get some SP swings here, and then Coach can keep working on 42 with Pode, and NIL can do that. All right, so Insight was okay. I have a feeling Instinct is going to be worse. Thanks, I need to get healed up as well. So this is absolutely an ALEPH class. So ALEPH, for those of you who do not know, ALEPH is the top classification for any abnormality in the game, which means that they are the most powerful but also the most dangerous. And the fact that Tang Sok is able to hang at his level is pretty good. Unfortunately, we didn't get the ALEPHs that I wanted, but we did get an ALEPH. And ALEPHs are the backbone of a good run in Lobotomy Corporation. Good job, Tang Sok. I know it's scary, bro. I'm scared too. Okay. Clip account decreased for every 5 employees dead in the facility. However, did not recognize the death of employees who were disposed of execution. Okay, so yeah. So that is the first time that we have an abnormality here that actually hinges off of employee deaths, employees including the pawns. So now we have a situation where we need to be proactive at saving pawns or executing them. So we kind of reduced when the result was bad. Increase whenever the club counter increases whenever an abnormality is suppressed. Whenever an abnormality, so that's any abnormality. So we can counteract that. It decreases for every 5 employees dead, but we can counteract that by letting out an abnormality. So this is where Scarecrow comes into play. So now Scarecrow has a much bigger role to play here in this playthrough, because now we can use him to counteract this ALEPH, and that's huge. That's pretty significant here. The Scarecrow is going to be vastly more important now than ever. Because we can, and the reason why I say Scarecrow is because we can just beat up on Scarecrow. We can just whoop him, no problem. And with our first Crimson Dawn coming up, that's going to be a good test to see how well our employees handle dealing with a new threat. We need to stay proactive in protecting the pawns, but also get ready to execute them. I don't know what the Klovov counter by default is for this abnormality. I know I've seen it once. It's not Melted Love or Melting Love. I remember it's bad though. That's the only thing I remember is that abnormality is not great. Coach work there, little Daisy. Actually, we need to slow our roll here. Parasite tree is almost done. Let Husky do the parasite tree. Shout out to Tang Sok for beast moding this ALEPH. That's real good. When an employee with lower than level 3 encounters the escaped it, they lose control and attack of employees. The same happens with the employee whose mental health reaches zero by its attack. So it turns people against it, but that doesn't mean that we can't recover them. God. This is the audio record of the first contact with this abnormality. Omitted. Employee Serena. I feel threatened because you are armed, and that bright pink disturbs me as well. It doesn't belong here. What's your opinion on the nature of human, employee Serena? Not humans, but human. Again, there are some translation issues. Boy, Serena, I think it depends on the person's experience. Why do you ask? It is a highly debatable topic, but this is what we think we should do. If a person is good from the start, we protect their good heart. If a person is bad from the start, we will make a good heart out of them and protect it. How are you going to do it? We can see the color of heart. The color of human heart is pink. By wearing the same color, we blend into the people's mind. We will gladly get dirty for the good-hearted people. Wait, you will get dirty instead of people? Is that possible? It is. I'm sorry, but I just can't trust you. It's awfully suspicious that you can see the color of people's heart. If anything happens, just call us, ma'am. End of recording. According to the recording, the abnormality's will to help employees is solid. We have yet to grasp detailed information about this abnormality. Perhaps actually asking for help could help us get some more info. However, just like any other abnormality, we cannot blindly trust it. I'm planning to have a fire team ready when I pretend to request for help. Yeah. Yeah. Except we're not going to. Okay. We have Crimson Dawn coming up. We know how to handle this one. We're going to wait for Husky to get out. Wait, Husky? Why did I send Husky? I should have sent Force there. Oh, either way, we'll let Force start this one. The Husky's going to receive the blessing of the World Tree. My dang on that one. Force is working with 8% down, but he still should be okay in Bob armor. All right, here we go. We need to be careful of employee deaths. I don't know what until I know what the clip off counter is for this, I don't know if we can handle. I'm not sure if we can handle allowing a few employees to die here. Okay, Tank Sox should get that one. You guys handle this one. Okay, so I need to give a red shield to any pawn that's around the Jester. Because the Jester's explosion is more than enough to make them die, and we don't want that. And we especially don't want this thing to get out. Okay, so that's done. So, just to play it safe, because I think we lost an employee up here, a pawn up here. So just to play it safe, let's let Scarecrow get out, and then we're just gonna beat him down real quick. And yeah. So Scarecrow, we're gonna let out. I'm not going to work on the heart yet. Okay, we have Green Noon coming up next. Savicta is done with that. I'm gonna keep him in this hallway here. Not protect any pawn who tries to walk in front of him, like this one here. Doing red damage or black damage? Doesn't matter. Okay, so that should have brought the clip off counter back of this abnormality up again. And whenever you're working with an abnormality that you don't know, you have to take all precautions, because the game is, as you all have plainly seen, the game is not going to hold your hand. So we're taking extreme caution when it comes to this ALEPH over here. We have the green noon coming up. Green noon is, again, we saw it in the first day here on this episode. It's not that bad. Dude, seriously, shout out to Tangsock for absolutely beast moding this ALEPH. I cannot say enough how important that is to have someone who can handle an ALEPH like that, who isn't even in ALEPH armor, by the way. The army in pink. It's a Zayn? Yeah. Okay, whatever you say. Whatever you say, game, whatever you say. It's just, remember, it has the appearance of wanting to help humans. I want to point that out, so it's trying to trick us right now. It's masking its own class. A lot happened until now. To summarize the whole story, this abnormality is the best thing we've ever had. For months ago, I tried my chance by asking for help to this abnormality. And I've been using it since then. I got help about redacted times. My efficiency at work has gotten much better. At this point, just looking at pink soothes my mind. Those creatures bolsters in the way that even the greatest leader can't. Boister and whatever other Pokemon you want. That abnormality will greatly improve our employees' quality of life. Yeah, all right. Okay. So Tang Sock should be good to work one more time here. Well, he needs to recover Sandy first. Stupid Tree is looking stupid. We should probably wait on this. Let's have Force go in. Then we will let Little Daisy kick it off. All right, so Green Noon, we know what to do here. But we got to be careful. Remember, we now exist in a situation where we cannot afford to lose pawns. Losing pawns may now actually be extremely catastrophic. So let's take stock of where the pawns are going. There's already two pawns walking there. This one doesn't have any pawns next to it yet. This one's in an empty room. This one doesn't have any pawns walking to it yet. So this is our top priority to save right now. Is these two jokers. And remember, I could just simply execute them, but I'm trying not to. Okay, so now they've swapped here. Okay, so that one's almost dead. We don't have to worry about that one. That one has a pawn on it. Coach Crendor over here. They've got Baynard, and that one's almost dead anyway. We'll help Tang Sok as soon as Team NL is done. Okay, so that one's done. Team NL, come help out Tang Sok. Team Baynard's done. Yeah, there we go. So it's only Team Tang Sok now. Okay, that was good. Now, again, because we don't know what the clip-off counter is of this Oh, it's at 3. Never mind. We do know it. Okay, yeah, so 3 is fine. So we can work with that. Good job, team. Well done. All right, let's try getting some attachment work. You know what? I think NL can handle attachment work over there. So the army in pink, I don't recall what its gear is like. It's eerily similar to another abnormality called Melted Love, as you've heard me mention already many times during this video. The Baynard gets a little bit of work. Force got the ears. I gotta tweet a picture of Force now to him. Force got the ears, man. It's his dream. Force Strategy Gaming always wanted to be an elf. Well, now here's his chance. The Tank Sock, go back to work here. Okay, so it is weak to red damage. That's good to know. Audio recording. Voice arena. You can do it again, right? Yes, human heart is pink, and we wear the same color. We will drive away bad thoughts. Did you get it? Yes, it's still in the best condition. We can put this abnormality to use again in our next suppression. They're much better than human soldiers. Please consider to officially designate them as the company's fire team. For a side note, it got a bit darker, but I don't think that's a big deal. Human heart is... We must clean. Even a speck of evil must be clean. It seems a bit less energetic than usual, but it's going to be fine, I think. Dun, dun, dun. Yeah, I'm sure it's going to be fine, Serena. Have none of you learned anything about this game? Little Poe Day. Let Baynard go. There we go. Yeah, spreading the love around. NL came over to Teams Invicta for once. Oh my god. It's a pink sniper rifle. What? What? And the ego gift is a pink helmet. Dude, that's awesome. SP plus 5, attack speed plus 5. Wow. Increases the damage of this abnormality's weapon by 15%. Holy smokes. That is actually incredible. Urgent report of the incident related to Army in Pink. We're filing this urgent report to related to the drastic change in Army in Pink. We're still trying to grasp what exactly happened. Total redacted employees have ceased. This is the audio recording of the assumed first casualty, employee Serena. Audio recording. Employee Serena. An abnormality has broken out again in the sector. I'd like to ask you for help again. Yes, we Army in Black blend into the human hearts and drive away good thoughts. What? That's not your line. Human heart is black. We must regularly clean. What are you talking about? You're creeping me out. We will protect you with our black love. Stop. I will call the fire team if you move a muscle there. I salute to you, ma'am. So, that's cool. All right. So, now we have an ALEPH to farm here, and there is no way I'm not going to continue to farm this one. Essentially, what I'm going to do for the rest of this video is just farm up the gear to get from Army in Black, which is no longer Army in Pink, as you can see. So, yeah. I don't think that that's going to make a good YouTube video, though, so what I'll probably do is I'll wrap it up here, but if something drastic does happen, I will make a separate recording and add that to tomorrow's video. But I am going to wrap up this video here now as we are kind of in the maintenance stage. So thank you all very much. I do appreciate the support of the Lobotomy Corporation series. If you enjoyed the series, kindly consider clicking the subscribe button, also with the like button. Leave a comment down below. Tell me who your favorite ALEPH is so far from Season 3 or Season 4. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.